Hello and welcome to another episode of Super Chats. I'm Jorge Luis Arredondo, Superintendent at FAR San Juan Alamo ISD. In honor of National Parental Involvement Day, I'm here today with some of our incredible team members from our Family and Community Engagement Department. They've been helping us keep our parents engaged and they've connected us throughout this virtual instruction. I'm gonna allow them to introduce themselves and let them tell a little bit about the role that they have been helping us in here at the FAR San Juan Alamo ISD Independent School District. We'll start off with you, Berta Robles.
Good morning. Good morning, sir. I'm a parent educator, sir. I do dual responsibilities. My role as a parent educator is at Clover Elementary. And I also co-manage the parent center, the site at the Alamo Bowie Center. I'm the evening site manager, and that is my role within the district and our department.
Thank you. Thank you for joining us, Ms. Robles. And now we have Priscilla Salinas. Tell us a little bit about your role.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Good morning. My name is Priscilla Salinas. I am the parent educator. I do work with the parentals. I work with the School of Liberty Middle School and Kelly. And as you are aware, Kelly's a blue school to now.
Yes, so it's a national blue ribbon school.
Yeah.
And I'm sure that would not be possible if it wasn't for the hard work and effort that all the faculty make, but particularly our parents and the role that you play in making sure that our parents are working together as partners.
Right.
Exactly.
And I'm glad to be there. So, and what we do right now with Liberty, I'm being a mentor to several of our students. I have several students, especially on the eighth grade. And Kelly, what we do is to see how they're doing, especially on this pandemic, how it's coming along. I have to be there supportive. And like I tell them over and over, I will help you as much as I can. And I try to go ahead and give them all the advice that I can to support them with this pandemic that we're going through.
Thank you, thank you. Now, something that I usually go around saying as first as a parent, but also as the superintendent, I like to let parents know how important their role is being their child's first teacher and best teacher. What are some areas that you all, many parents may not be familiar, but what are some ways on how you all help assist parents to give them those opportunities to really partner with the campus, as well as opportunities where they can assist their child in their development? And we'll go back to Ms. Robles.
Sir, one of the challenges I feel right now with our parents and is technology. Is the zooming into to classes, having them virtually show up for meetings and you know, being probably sitting right next to their children throughout the day. That's for now is a challenge. And I've found that if we communicate with our parents one-on-one, we get more of more information from them. Because then we sit and just listen to them and let them tell us what's going on at home. And then we just go from there. And they'll ask for help. They'll ask for suggestions. And that's where we then take off and look to the different departments in our district so that we can help them with whatever situation they may be going through at home. Be it with our special ed department, dual language, or, you know, just our department itself. So the fact that we're at home in front of our computer doesn't mean that we don't reach out and have one-on-one conversations with our parents. We stay connected.
Absolutely. And here we are in 2020, and we're having these virtual conversations, and we're seeing each other basically in each other's homes, right? And it's about having that relationship. And so I like the role that you're sharing it, that in many ways, you all help serve as liaisons to help bridge and make those connections with our teachers as well as other departments that could be supportive. Priscilla, what can you share about your role and how we connect parents?
Okay, the way that I've been connecting with parents, and I speak for both schools, so it's middle schools and elementary schools. It's like I said, I'm being, you know, I have a list of students that students and parents that I call, in fact, today, and I will follow up with them on Friday. The reason that I feel that it's really important is because a lot of these parents are, this is just new and they're scared. So the first thing that I do, I welcome them. I tell them, you know, to be honest, I use my personal phone and I do give them a call and welcome and thank them, you know, that they're not alone. They're not alone. And here we are, as much as they want to know, we'll help them. And if for some reason or another, I don't have the answers, I'm very good at seeking for help, especially our teamwork, as in what we do as a cohort. We'll call, we have messages. So what I do, I call them, I text them, I follow up, I give them the grade. And the final thing is, like I always tell them, exactly what you just said, they're the role models. So it comes from the house. So I tell them, don't be afraid. You know, I know that you're used to being out in school, the teachers, but you are a teacher. So I give them positive motivations before anything, and they're so welcome of everything that we do. In elementary, we're in the same boat. In elementary, what they really like about me, and the parents can say that they like to hear my voice, because it says, Miss Salinas, you're always positive and you'll find answers, you know, you'll call. And I have real good communications with administrators from Liberty and Middle. And I don't know, I don't know if it is true, but a lot of the parents says, Miss, everywhere you go, you know, you can get across. You know, you can get across and you give us a positive answer. And that's how I work with them. Everything has to be positive, regardless of where we stand.
Excellent, excellent. You know, I wanna say that you all are not just liaisons to our parents, but sounds like you all are also ambassadors to Far San Juan Alamo ISD, because in many ways you are advocating for the great work that we're doing, and you're also demonstrating that positive energy that we know we like to display here in PSJA, right? Because we're all part of the PSJA family. Now, during a regular school year, we know how critical it is to have parent volunteers, as they play a critical role in supporting our schools and our teachers. But this pandemic has changed a lot of things. And one of those is, you know, like you said, you have to pick up the phone and sometimes make that connection. And sometimes you also have to connect with them virtually if it's possible. So even though we are currently operating mostly virtual for the health and safety of all our PSJ family, what are some ways our parents right now can continue to stay active and be empowered to provide those critical ideas, support for their children here at PSJA? And we'll go back to you, Ms. Robles. And then Priscilla, when you answer that question, if you could kind of talk a little bit about, you know, how sometimes as we transition as parents from elementary to middle school, we think, well, yeah, a lo mejor ya, hijo, you know, I'll kind of stand back and I won't visit so much the campus, but how important it still is, even at the middle school and the high school level. But we'll start off with you, Ms. Robles.
Dr. Redondo, I'm going to talk about our volunteers at the center, at the Bowie mm-hmm. Center. At the moment, our volunteers are still very active. We have our, like I mentioned, a volunteer math tutor that is tutoring the material that's needed for their GED certificate. We also have a volunteer instructor that does gramática in Espanol for our parents who wanted to learn grammar. We also have our entrepreneurship classes, and all of those instructors are volunteer instructors that used to be at our center that are now with us virtually. We have a culinary class, we have an arts and crafts class, we have a sewing class, we have cake decorating, and it's all continuing continued from the center to now virtually, and they're all volunteer instructors. We have up to 30 or 40 parents remoting into our sessions. These classes are in the evening, so they're at 6 o'clock. Sometimes it's 7:30 and we're still on the computer with these group of parents that go from one class to the other. And they come from their ESL class, that's probably a 2 or 3, and then they just switch into their arts and crafts class or the cake decorating, and they call it a stress releaser. You know, they go to their English class. As a matter of fact, sir, I'm the volunteer instructor for arts and crafts, excuse me, and I was giving the class in Spanish, and I got schooled by my parents because I was giving this class in Spanish, and then one of the parents, Ms. Antonio, raised her hand and she said, "Mrs. Robles, can you please give us this class in English? We're attending our English class, then we come to arts and crafts and you speak to us in Spanish. We're trying to learn English and you're giving the class in Spanish." And, you know, I thought, yeah, it's true. So she said, if we get to a word that we don't understand in English, we'll ask you to stop and explain it in Spanish. And, but can you please give us a class in English? And I thought, that's awesome, sir. We're doing arts and crafts, and they still bring the English into the volunteer, the entrepreneurship class that's supposed to be a fun class. And so I had to change my language from Spanish to English, but they're very active, sir. As they, like I said, we have anywhere from 30 to 40 parents at all our classes. And I also have classes in the evening. I have four ESL classes with Region 1, and I also have an STC class also with Region 1. So our center is very active at the moment, even though we don't get to go and be there in person. But, you know, it's full of parents. We've got maybe up to 600 parents right now registered, Dr. Redondo, at our center.
Wow.
So
over 600 parents?
I think the last time I noticed, sir, we were one parent away from having 600 registered.
Wow.
Yes.
Well, thank you. Thank you. Thank you for your efforts and making sure that we're building the capacity of our parents and listening to them. I think it's always super important that as we in our role to want to educate, that we're also listening so that we can better meet the needs of all our parents. Priscilla, would you like to share?
Sure. Okay, I have real good communications with my old volunteers and plus new ones that I've been recruiting. And believe it or not, they say that they can't see me, the parents, because see, like I'm being... I'm trying to recruit them at the same time I'm talking to them and giving positive motivations for them to succeed with their children. And then this is what they say. Well, my old one says, "Ay, miss, ¿cuándo vamos a salir de esta rueda? Dice, porque yo ya estoy lista, porque yo quiero que me enseñe technology, you know, tecnología." And they talk a lot of Spanish, sir. And I said, "Sí, sí, sí lo vamos a poder hacer, que sí, en Liberty." Because Liberty gave me a computer area where they can go ahead and sit down and do like at least 1 hour. Mr. Carrillo is really good in giving those classes, you know, and not only, the only thing that he did mention to me, and he said, you know, 1 or 2 hours, you know, this is your room, this is your area and things like that. And Kelly, well, we have laptops. So they're ready to go. And people that I haven't met, but I met them over the phone, they're ready too. He said, and she says, "Wow, miss, dice, yo no sabía que usted era así, así. Puedo imaginar cómo se mira, yo la puedo imaginar." And so I talk about my experience and my child and the way it sounds in the phone, they always think I'm younger. And I say, "Yo ya tengo mi edad." And they say, "No importa, pero se oye con mucha energía y estoy..." I want to see you. I want to meet you. You know, the first person when I go into that school, when we go back, I'm going to ask for you. And I said, "Oh, that's so nice." I says, but they're looking forward. I have not yet lost my volunteers. It's like Ms. Robles says, I have 15 to 20 on Liberty. In Kelly, I have the same, and I could probably have more. But see, the thing, many times too, sir, is just the space area. Because mm-hmm. in our school, is like they go in groups. They go in groups and they call each other and they chat. It says, this is the time that we're going to go. So we get things done, you know, when they're there, they're real helpful, but they're looking forward. Mm-hmm. They just wish they could do it now, but they're going to have patience. They do not say, I'm not going to go. We're looking forward. And especially I tell them, well, I might be moving to another school. Well, usted se va para esa escuela, pues yo también me voy para esa escuela. So they're really looking forward to, and they said, we're not changing any schools from the school district. You know, our PSJ is number one, you know, because they're like always in competition because PSJ High and Raiders, but they're looking forward. They're really looking forward to learning more.
Excellent. And what are some tips that you share with parents to continue to stay engaged, particularly when they transition from elementary to middle school and then from middle school to high school?
What I tell them to stay engaged is that, you know, that they have all, like Ms. Robles said, that they have all these capabilities to continue their education if they want to, because we do have that. Not mm-hmm. only that, if for some reason or another that they want to learn arts and crafts, for them to encourage themselves to learn English if they don't, you know, there's always something. And being with the school district, not only that, but encourage them to be closer to their students, you know, to their children. And at the same time, like I have some volunteers too, and I said, this is, and it's honestly, truthfully, I said, Miss, I am getting my GED. A lot of them got their GED. They're learning more English because they do it. Like Miss Robles says, they want me to talk to them in English. So we kind of play it like a game. If they don't talk in English, they get to lose like a point. I teach them what teachers do in class. I do the same thing. Okay, today we're going to talk English. So I encourage them, you know, to continue, because if they don't continue, well, then they're going to lose track of what's going on. So they're real happy. And they always says how we wish that everybody's the same, you know, where we are going, an extra mile. And, but I said, they can, it's just a little bit of training, like the same way that you do. You know, I always tell them to stay on with us with PSJ. We have all of these technologies, Another thing that I always tell them, no les falta nada para sus niños tampoco.
Mm-hmm.
Si les falta, hablen conmigo. Believe
That's
it
right.
or not. The communication, and they love it because I do, like I said, I have real good communication with my administrators. And
Thank
if
you.
Not, I said, lo que podemos hacer, nomás hablarle a Mr. Redondo que está pasando.
Absolutely. Anytime. You definitely can give me a call and let your principal know, let me know, and we're going to do everything we can because we want to provide the best customer service. And one of the things that we're also doing, we have a survey, right, that right now where we're doing a parent survey because we want to know how their social-emotional learning state is right now as well and what other needs our parents have. So if you have not completed that survey for the parents that are out there, please be sure to do so. We're doing that right now. And then as I just want to, you know, I'm so proud of the work that you all are doing as ambassadors, as parent liaisons, and as advocates for our students to get a quality education. And also being there that if there's no barrier that we can't overcome when we work together. So on behalf of our PSJ family, I want to thank you for your hard work and your dedication. And as we wrap up this episode, is there anything else you'd like to share? And Ms. Robles?
All I wanted to share, sir, is that our centers are open, our PSJ doors are open. I think our parents are aware of that. We stay in close contact with them. We do one-on-one meetings with them. And like Priscilla said, she uses her personal phone. So do I, because I want them to have my phone number. And I don't want them to feel like they don't have that connection with us. And so I use my phone. They call me sometimes in the evening because they want to contact a teacher or they want to know if Mr. Garcia, my principal at Clover, is at their campus. And so I just think that an open door policy for our parents is the key. And that's the message that that I relay with them.
Thank you. Ms. Salinas, Priscilla Salinas?
Yes, I want to go ahead and let them know that we're here and whatever they need, we have open doors. And like I said, like I do have my personal phone. I don't close doors. And if I don't have the answer, I seek for it, for them not to be like scared of anything. Because like you said, we work as a team. We'll find answers mm-hmm. and we want them to continue their education as in with their students and the parents too.
Absolutely, and we're always here to assist them. And if there's any, please don't hesitate to contact us. As you can see, we have some great parent specialists in, that will help, as well as principals, counselors, teachers. Well, I wanna just take time to really thank both of you all for joining me today. And on behalf of our entire school district, we wanna thank all of you all for everything that you're doing. Particularly, my hat goes out to, a big shout out to all the parents. I was helping my daughter Friday night because she had an essay that she was working on, and it never stops, right? And I'm very fortunate that I'm able to assist my daughter and spend that time with her. But I also know the challenges that other parents may have, particularly as subjects get more and more difficult. So please know that our teachers are here to assist you. We have other supports in our district that can help you. So thank you very much to all the parents for doing all the work that you're doing. And like we said, don't keep something with yourself. Reach out to one of us and we'll do everything we can to help you. To our viewers, thank you. Thank you very much for listening. Make sure you follow us on social media and visit our website for the latest news. You can follow the PSJA Parent Engagement Department on Facebook and Twitter at PSJA Parent Engagement. We pray for your continued health and stay safe, PSJA family.